Hi guys, Craptronics Teardown Time today. It is a combo radio, CD, MP3 player I found in the dumpster. And it seems very, very crappy. So it is made by Luxia, or at least it is the brand on it. On the back here we have the model number of this piece of crap. Luxia Musicality 102M, made in China, of course. So it is a tuner with CD player with apparently MP3 compatibility, but no USB or SD socket or nothing. And the CD player is not working. It is probably why it has been discarded. So as you can see, it has quite an alien design with two very small speakers, 5 mm. So first the user interface. On the top we have a CD player. There is no locking mechanism on this CD door. That's just to lift it. It is quite flimsy. We have an handle here. The edge is a little sharp, I believe. It is not very comfortable to keep it on. But at least the back is filled with the cover. It is not hollow. The antenna here, lots of vent holes, oddly enough. On the front we have the display for the CD player. I believe it is just 2 digits numerical display, LCD display. We have a power LED. We have CD player functions, so repeat here, back here, next here, program, play, pause, stop, and folder or track skip. We change apparently MP3 folders. On this side we have the tuner control. So it is a very not precise tuner control. It is almost impossible to tune correctly in a station. Here the main function switch, either off, CD or MP3 or aux. Quite weird, you have. It means you switch on the auxiliary input at the same time you have a CD player connected. And FM and AM tuner. On the back side we have a mains socket. We have very conveniently placed phones plug jack, as you can see. It is really convenient to go at the back of the device to plug your headphones. Auxiliary input jack, and here the volume control. At the bottom we just have the battery cover. It is quite not staying very well in place, and the thing can work with 6 C batteries. So there is no manufacturing stamps on the plastic parts, it seems. And it seems to be very crude molding. It is ABS, and here we have another model number. It is a CD6100. Okay, so this, I don't know what it is. So we will try it a little bit, at least in a radio mode. So it is impossible to have a clear signal with no or noise in the signal. And tuning a FM station is really, really difficult because the button lacks of a lot of precision. But it is almost impossible to tune something correctly. And it is not because the antenna is not opened, it is the same with the antenna opened. Here we have the AM, I don't think we have anything in AM anymore. No. And you can see the very, very little window here for the dial. By the way, it is really, really a pain, this thing. The CD player, when I switch it on, in fact, it does nothing. I guess this display should lift ID tray with a CD, and nothing happens. Okay, now we will take it apart. So, on the bottom we have the screws, and beside each screw we have an arrow to indicate you must, you have to remove the screw for repair. And beside also we have, at each time, one little electrical shock hazard label. For each screw it is quite weird. And yes, at the back here, lots of cautions. We have CE marking for European countries only, for export to European countries. We have FCC marking for USA. I don't know if it is the correct logo or not. Here, that seems to be a serial number. So if so, it means it was made in 2013. So it is only 2 years old. And we have lots of cautions about splashing water on it, about FCC rules compliance, about risk of electric shock do not open, about laser radiation hazard. Okay, so let's cut this piece open. I guess we just have to remove the plastic, the screws in the plastic. Here we have two screws probably keeping in place part of the front side. And yes, of course, they are really, really shitty little screws. So I hope it is not filled with bugs inside. Sometimes you have nasty surprises when you take stuff in the dumpsters. I don't think so, it has not the smell of a cockroach, so. The worst thing I ever found in a device I took apart was a dead mouse. Okay. So, now it is filled with hot glue. Here we are, at least we have plugs. So on this bottom side, as you can see, lots of hot glue to keep things in place. We have a transformer, mains transformer, directly connected to the, it seems, yes, to the power plug, and I don't not see any fuse. So it seems there is an a switch in the here to switch the batteries in and out when you plug the AC, but I do not see any fuse in this thing. I need to check it right now. I did believe this cover is was here was a fuse, but no, there is nothing behind it. But obviously there is a provision for something here. To yes, two screw posts. And now we have no fuse in this thing. So maybe there is at least a thermal fuse inside the transformer. But it is not terribly good. This must be the power supply stage. We have 4 diodes and 1 capacitor, which is flying in the breeze. And by the way, the brand of the capacitor is the famous Chang's brand. It is the same brand you can buy when you get capacitor bags in on Dilextreme or on eBay, cheapo eBay capacitors in bags. They are usually this brand. So we can see, so at least the internal wiring has the connectors. So it can be reused for something maybe. And nothing else here. Here, so you have the main body screws. Here we have, so as you can see, we have a front panel which separates like so. We have four screws to separate the front panel. And we have this main PCB. We will start with this one. So the tuner capacitor, variable capacitor here, old school, like in old transistor radios. Really nothing fancy here. So many screws on this board. Yes, so I have to disconnect stuff. This is the antenna wire. Here one connector to undo. The CD drive connector here. Oh, it is nice, guys. Okay, so here is a nice work on this PCB, as you can see. All the capacitors flip on the side. And always the chunks, brand. So, all over the place. Here we have some power transistor with a little piece. It is a little piece of phenolic PCB with a copper side here. So I do not know if they opt to use it as a heat sink, but the PCB is not a good heat conductor, so really it is quite sad, this design. We have here probably the audio amplifier chip with steel heatsink on it. We have one transistor here on the side, or maybe, no, it is a 7805. It is a voltage regulator. So at least it will be possible to retrieve some parts because the legs are long on the components. So if they are not, if they are working, I can unsolder them and reuse some of them. Here we have an AM antenna with lots of watts on it. The far position switch for power. And they did attach the button on it with a bit of melting of the plastic, probably with a soldering iron, yes, because there is even some solder here. Okay, so really, really not impressed here. It is just like any cheap Chinese transistor radio, in fact. On the back, we have some chips. This seems to be a motor controller for the CD drive. Yes, it is connected to the motors. Here, some chip made from my Eli. This seems to be a memory chip, Century brand, 1440ASG-70. Probably it is for keeping temporary data for the CD drive for the when you program the tracks or folder data for reading the MP3s. So this must be an all-in-one chip doing regular audio CD and MP3 decoding. There is a quartz oscillator here for it, probably. About the soldering work, well, some of the SMDs are sideways, like this one. The solder seems not too terribly bad, at least. It could be worse, I guess. But there is always this kind of strange white deposit white stuff on the clip PCB like this. I don't know what it is. Okay, then next in here we have front panel, I guess. It can be removed with two screws here, it looks like. Yes. So we have one zip tie here at least. So here are the two speakers with some glue on them. They are 4 ohm 2 watt speakers. Here we have at the bottom some kind of date code stamp, stamp map, but it is not filled. Here we have the CD 6100 tag, so it is must be the real model name for the manufacturer. And it is written SEM Industries Hong Kong. There is even a phone number and an email address, so we know who made it. It is in fact this brand, SEM. And there is a warning. Copyrighted design. Legal action will be taken against any copying or infringement. I do not know if taking this apart is an infringement or not. So here at the front we have control PCB with one clip-on board for driving the display probably, or maybe the interfacing with the controller chip for the CD player, the commands here. So I will take it apart later, but nothing else of interest here. And the last part here, the very very generic CD player, I guess. Nothing special. It must be purchased from another company, probably. So the thing is not too terribly bad, not extremely dangerous, except for the lack of fuse, maybe. But not good also. And really, it is not working well. I did just spot here. Look at this. Big blob of solder on the variable capacitor. So for sure this has been put in place after the main soldering and it was unsoldered. So here we have the CD mechanism. Yes, as you can see it is something very generic. There is no brand on it whatsoever. Oh, it does not look terribly good, this drive mechanism. It is slipping quite a bit. So I guess when you are when your grease is coming dry on this thing, you will have problems, or if one of these plastic parts here break, you will have problems also. If the other parts are not already dead. Well, here nothing else except the... here we have the interlock for the laser door at least. And spring for the door. Antenna with ferrite piece. And it's all. Okay, so as expected, it is not impressive at all, the quality of construction of this thing. At least there is a few parts which can be retrieved, maybe. And the other parts will return to the dumpster. So, thanks for watching, bye bye.